Welcome to Chem Help ASAP. This video describes the recently approved drug, QUIZARTINIB, sold under the brand name Vanflyta. This video emphasizes the MedChem properties of the drug rather than the clinical pharmacology. If you happen to be a scientist who worked on this project and are at liberty to speak about this research or your general work at Daiichi Sankyo, I would be very interested in interviewing you for a separate video. The channel email address is in the video description. The approval of QUIZARTINIB's NDA was granted on the 20th of July in 2023. The active ingredient is QUIZARTINIB, which is the U.S. adopted name. The branded name of the drug is Vanflyta. QUIZARTINIB is an oral drug and is administered either as a 17.7 milligram or 26.5 milligram daily dose. QUIZARTINIB's indication includes various forms of acute myeloid leukemia, or AML. Daiichi Sankyo sponsored the NDA. All this information can be found through the prescribing information of QUIZARTINIB through the link at the bottom of the screen. QUIZARTINIB is approved to treat AML, specifically for AML patients with internal tandem duplication mutations of FLT3. FLT3 is a receptor tyrosine kinase, specifically FMS-related receptor tyrosine kinase 3. So FLT3 ITD is the target for AML drugs, including QUIZARTINIB. The ITD mutation is found in approximately 23% of AML patients, especially in advanced AML patients. Therefore, FLT3 ITD is an established target for AML treatment. There are multiple compounds that are active against FLT3 ITD. Of course, newly approved QUIZARTINIB is one example. Two others are sorafenib, which was approved back in 2005 by the FDA. Gilteritinib is another example with approval in 2018. Both sorafenib and gilteritinib are approved for multiple indications, but AML is one of the approved indications. Here are some standard physicochemical properties of QUIZARTINIB. So the structure has a molecular weight of around 560 grams per mole. For an oral drug, that is a fairly high molecular weight and technically in violation of Lipinski's rules, or the rule of five. None of the other Lipinski criteria, log P, hydrogen bond acceptors, and donors, are in violation. So with just one violation, molecular weight, QUIZARTINIB is still technically Lipinski compliant. Regardless, the drug is still fairly large for an oral drug. If we look into the potency of QUIZARTINIB, then we can analyze the drug in a couple different ways. So the potency, the KD of QUIZARTINIB, is 1.26 nanomolar based on IUPAR's guide to pharmacology. This is excellent potency, but of course, as a larger molecule, QUIZARTINIB has a larger surface area for more intermolecular forces and a greater potency. Based on the potency, we can estimate a binding energy for QUIZARTINIB as 12.1 kcals per mole. From the binding energy, we can calculate some composite parameters. The first is ligand efficiency, which is the binding energy divided by the heavy atom count. The ligand efficiency is about 0.30 kcals per mole per heavy atom, which is a reasonable number for an oral drug. A higher ligand efficiency indicates that the compound structure is more highly optimized on a per atom basis. The second composite parameter is lipophilic efficiency, or LipE. LipE describes the trade-off between potency and lipophilicity, log P. A value of 4.3 is reasonably good, so QUIZARTINIB checks out based on both of these metrics. A co-crystal of QUIZARTINIB with FLT3 has been published. Here is a static image from the co-crystal. Most of the structure of FLT3 has been removed for clarity. Note that I think this is FLT3, wild-type FLT3, and not FLT3 ITD, the mutated form. This static image is fine, but let's look at the co-crystal. PDB entry 4XUF in a browser on the PDB website. Here is the co-crystal in the default view on PDB. FLT3 is shown as a ribbon diagram, and quizartinib is a ball and stick. You can see that quizartinib is really enveloped by FLT3. By no means am I an expert on kinase inhibitors like quizartinib, but those who are experts are well acquainted with all the key binding positions afforded by receptor kinases like FLT3 and how these key positions can be exploited to gain selectivity by the inhibitor for one kinase over another. Not an easy task. Let's change the view a bit. And strip away some of the non-essential parts of FLT3. And now we can better see the intermolecular forces, the dotted lines between quizartinib and FLT3. As a well-optimized structure, essentially all the parts of quizartinib are engaged in some kind of interaction with FLT3. An exception is this morpholine in the bottom right, which is probably helping the solubility of the compound. Okay, moving to the key PK parameters, we can see that the half-life of quizartinib is quite long. 81 hours. Contributing to that long half-life is a low clearance and moderate volume of distribution. For such a large structure with a high molecular weight, quizartinib has a quite high bioavailability of 71%. Plasma protein binding is extensive at 99%. Finally, quizartinib is essentially only cleared by the liver, as unchanged renal excretion is less than 2%. I say that hepatic metabolism is the main route of clearance, but keep in mind that the total clearance of quizartinib is very low. So while quizartinib is cleared hepatically, its rate of clearance is regardless quite modest. The one notable metabolite of quizartinib is AC886. This compound arises from an omega oxidation of one of the T-butyl methyl groups through phase 1 CYP3A4-3A5 oxidation. AC886 is interesting because it retains on-target activity and is therefore a pharmacologically active metabolite. In fact, the half-life of AC886 is quite long, longer than quizartinib, and well over 100 hours. So a large portion of the therapeutic benefit of quizartinib arises from the circulating concentration of its metabolite. Quizartinib does have serious safety risks. It is a hERG inhibitor, and hERG inhibitors can pose a cardiovascular risk for patients. In fact, the bullet points on this slide are in a box because the risks of quizartinib are serious enough to warrant a boxed warning on the drug. Both quizartinib and its active long-lived metabolite are hERG inhibitors and can lead to a prolonged QT interval, which can cause fatal irregular heart rhythms. Patients may need to be monitored through ECG, an electrocardiogram. The use of quizartinib with drugs that are known to be strong CYP3A inhibitors should be avoided, as drug-drug interactions may lead to further increased cardiovascular risk. In 2019, an NDA for quizartinib was rejected by the FDA because the available clinical data did not strongly demonstrate that the benefit of the drug against AML outweighed potential risks. Only after additional clinical study was the FDA satisfied with the effectiveness of quizartinib to allow a successful NDA several years after the first application. The drug had been previously approved in Japan in 2019 and Europe in 2022. Those are some highlights for quizartinib, marketed as Vanflyta. Quizartinib is approved for use in advanced acute myeloid leukemia patients, specifically in patients with ITD mutations to FLT3. Thank you for watching to the end of this drug approval summary for quizartinib. Please consider subscribing to the channel, leaving a like, or making a comment. Take care.